Marcel Beugelsdijk from the Netherlands, owner of Bemint and specialized in Power Query. This is one of the videos about various topics in Power Query that all share the same elements, Power Query function, a value type. This video is about transforming column values using values from another column. In this table, I have bank transactions from various bank accounts with the fields date, bank account, the type of transaction, credit or debit, and the amount. All the amounts are positive, but I want to replace the amount by a negative amount if the type is debit. First, I will import the table into Power Query. From table range, change type, and the first column should be a date. Close and load to only create connection. Okay. Now I can reference this table in a new query. Rename it to transaction signed. If I would select the amount column and try to use the standard transform functions like multiply. I want to multiply the amount by minus one. Then there is no way I can reference other columns. In this case, the type column. So this won't work. And I will delete this step again. Instead, I can choose replace values. Value to find some dummy values, replace with two. Okay. Now I have some basic code using table replace value. I'll collapse the query so I have more space. And with table replace value, it is possible to reference other columns. So I can replace the one which is the old value. Now the old value is each amount. And I want to replace it by each if type is debit, then amount times minus one, else amount. Replace value for the amount column, that is okay. And now you can see the correct amounts. They are negative if the type is debit and positive if the type is credit. But as a result of using table replace value, all column types are reset to type any. In the source step, the columns were properly typed, and after replacing the values, all the column types are reset to any. So I want to restore the column types from the source step. So I create a new step and I use a value.replace type. So I want to replace the type of the replaced value step by the value type of the source step. So I get all the column names and column types from the source step applied to the table replaced value. So there they are. I will rename this step into restored types. And now I have the result I was looking for. So this is the end of this video. Thanks for watching. See you again in the next video in which the function value type will be used.